We're back for another session. I'm Gab. We hope you enjoyed our previous episodes. Today we'll be learning about gear to remote sensor. For a brief overview, let me discuss what remote sensor is. Well, remote sensor allows you to collect pedometer data, user activity events, or wearing states. Additionally, it supports Bluetooth for connection. In this tutorial, we will teach you how to recreate a sample pedometer application using the remote sensor SDK. Let's get started. We'll start off by gathering all the things we need to develop a remote sensor application with Gear 2. Make sure to have Eclipse with Android development tools installed. Make sure to have updated until the Jelly Bean packages. Jelly Bean is the minimum requirement to use Samsung remote sensor. We also need the following jar files. These will be used to introduce remote sensor to the device. These files can be found in the Samsung Mobile SDK 1.5 Beta Archive file. Also, make sure to have a Samsung Android smart device that has Jelly Bean OS or above, and a Samsung Gear 2. Install the following in order. If the order is revised, the remote sensor application may not work due to Android permissions. First, install Gear Manager, followed by the remote sensor service. You can download this from Samsung apps. And finally, the remote sensor application. We'll be doing this later for testing, but you can go ahead and download this from the sample application attached to this blog post. For those viewing directly from YouTube, simply go to developer.samsung.com and check out the tutorial entries. Let's learn the architecture and the classes of the remote sensor library. Basically, the layers are composed of the application layer, which is an application that uses remote sensor, the sensor protocol that is primarily responsible in accessing the wearable device sensor data, and finally, the remote sensor service and the wearable sensor service, which are responsible for Bluetooth connectivity. Let's proceed with the classes. First, the SRS class. This class provides methods for initializing the remote sensor package and for checking if remote sensor is supported. It has four methods: get version code, get version name, initialize, and is feature enabled. For is feature enabled, we have type gear manager, a constant used to check whether gear manager is supported or not, type gear fit manager, a constant used to check whether Gear Fit Manager is supported or not. And lastly, type Remote Sensor Service, a constant used to check whether Remote Sensor Service is supported or not. The SRS Remote Sensor Manager is a class that provides access to the wearable device sensor. Note that the system does not disable sensors automatically when the screen turns off. That is why always disable sensors when you do not need them, especially when your activity is on pause, as seen in the code displayed. Failure to do so can drain the battery in just a few hours. The SRS Remote Sensor Manager consists of four methods, namely get sensor list, register listener, request trigger sensor, and unregister listener. It has a nested class called SRS Remote Sensor Manager.EventListener, which is a listener interface that receives sensor data events. We shall see the use of this class once we proceed to our sample. The SRS Remote Sensor is an interface that provides remote sensor information. It provides several useful methods, such as retrieving the device type or version, getting how much power the sensor is using, inquiring the resolution of the sensor, and the like. The last one, SRS Remote Sensor Event. This class represents a sensor event and holds event information such as the sensor type, timestamp, accuracy, and sensor data. The values array depends on which sensor type is being monitored. Type user activity provides us three values, unknown state, walk, and run. Type pedometer gives us the value of the step counter. This event is updated every 5 minutes to reduce the power consumption of the wearable device. Type wearing state gives us two values, not wearing and wearing. Let's analyze the sample application. This is also similar to the sample from the Samsung Mobile SDK 1.5 beta. Let's open our Eclipse IDE. As you can see, we have an app named RS Demo with the API set to 18. Now let's check the libraries. It's complete. And the manifest permissions. These are to use the Bluetooth feature, as well as the accessory framework and remote sensor. So let's check out the XML file. Basically, these text views will display data for the wearable status, user activity, and pedometer data. The button will act as a refresh button, meaning this button will retrieve the data from the wearable device. Let's go to the main activity. On the onCreate method, we see SRS being initialized. We created the service manager as well. Moving on, let's check the onSensor value change method. Here we see how to retrieve from the values array. Scroll up. We see how data is retrieved from the wearable through the registered listeners and the speed of the sensor. All these methods are called under check info button. Now that we're done, let's test our application. Before that, remember to install Gear Manager and the remote sensor service. Make sure that the wearable and host device are connected successfully. Once those conditions are met, you can install the Android application and simply enable the pedometer in your Gear 2 device. Walk around to gather data, then tap on the Check User Info button on your Android application to retrieve the data on your wearable device. As you can see, the data is sent over your phone, over Bluetooth, via the remote sensor SDK. Isn't it amazing? Anyway, let's sum up the things we discussed to develop the application using Samsung remote sensor. Include the necessary SDK jar files in your project. Have Gear Manager and the remote sensor service installed before running your application. And don't forget the necessary manifest permissions. We hope this tutorial helped. For inquiries, please post your questions on the official forum at developer.samsung.com. Thanks for watching!